Thank you, Madam Chair. I have listened to each of you gentlemen with admiration. Thank you for your intellect and your service. Mr. Administrator, I know I don't need to tell you about the Michu Assembly Facility in Louisiana. We are we're NASA's rocket factory. We're very proud of it. A few years ago, a hurricane blew our roof off, and you helped us to get it repaired, and I want to thank you for that, Mr. Administrator. I want to ask for your help with our administration buildings, building number one, building number two. They were built, I think, in 1943. We're spending about $1 million a year in repair costs. We've certainly reached the point of diminishing returns. Can you help us get some new buildings there?
I can help you, but I need your help too. We have $5 billion of unfunded infrastructure needs. Give you an example. Last year, I was begging and borrowing and stealing to get the money for a little old bridge between Virginia and Maryland so it wouldn't fall in the water and we couldn't launch our rockets from Wallops Island, Virginia. And we shouldn't have to do that. I was trying to cut deals with Senator Richard Shelby in order to get that because it was a priority. But we've got $5 billion.
You can cut a deal with me.
Well, let me tell you, you've got 2,600 NASA employees in Louisiana. You've got that Michu facility. You've got 13 companies that are directly working on Artemis.
Yeah.
The body of that rocket is built right there outside of New Orleans.
Well, if we get you some funding for the infrastructure that we know you need, I hope you'll keep our need in mind with respect to those two administration buildings. Let me ask you about your work on the Mars Habitation and Life Support Systems. I know we talked about it in past committee testimony, and we had some language in the appropriations bill. Basically, you've got a manufacturer, as I appreciate it, mock-up and eventual habitats for your missions to Mars. Is that right?
I think you're referring to where we put people in an enclosure and try to simulate what it would be like for a year on the surface of Mars.
Yes.
That is going on, yes.
Can assembly centers like Michu play a role in that?
That, if I recall, is going on at the Johnson Space Center in Houston.
Yes, sir. We can do it better.
Well, I'm always for better, faster, and cheaper.
That's Michu. Better, faster, cheaper.
There you go.
Let's sit down and talk.
Okay.
Okay. Finally, in the time I have left, tell me about your SLS heavy lift rocket for the Artemis missions.
Well, the core of it is built right in Louisiana.
Yes, sir.
Then they stack the engines on it. They barge it up to not too far across the Louisiana-Mississippi line to the Stennis Space Center. They test the rockets, and then the assembled core of the rocket is barged to the Kennedy Space Center, where then vertically it is stacked in the vehicle assembly building. This next Artemis II that will go next year will start to be stacked this summer. The solid rockets first, and then the core stage that's made in Louisiana will be done this fall. We tested it without a crew. the rocket performed flawlessly. It was so good that we did a whole bunch of additional tests. But now the test is to put four human beings in that spacecraft on the top of the rocket. And that's the next mission, to check out all the life support systems in the spacecraft, which is the capsule on top called Orion. And then the third one is where we go into lunar orbit. They transfer into a SpaceX lander. It goes down. They stay 6 days on the surface. We're only going to send two of four astronauts down. They come back and rendezvous in lunar orbit and then come home.
My time's up. Doctor, thank you for your service. Thank you. Don't forget Louisiana.
Thank you. I would love to come and visit Louisiana.
You're welcome anytime.
One of the 10 regional innovation engines, Senator, last time you asked the question, if I can just take a minute.
Sure.
You said,
take all the time you need.
You said to me, we need to make sure that opportunities, ideas, talent is everywhere. We need to energize that everywhere. Senator, I'm very pleased to report that one of the 10 regional innovation engines, type 2, which is a large scale on energy, is in Louisiana. And we have launched it, and we are very happy to do it with the governor in an event that happened in Louisiana. So I just wanted you to know that. In addition to that, we have also got the National AI Research Resource pilots, and University of Louisiana Lafayette is one of those projects. So you'll be happy to know that we are taking this message of the entire nation has got capacity to contribute, and we should leverage that. So I just wanted you to.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Kennedy. Senator